Zimbabwe. 40 years of independence to us as young people. We celebrate the independence of our country. Some of us, we learned through a history of what this country was, that it was a journey from 1890, where the colonialists came and colonized us and displaced our forefathers from the land which they owned. And they took political independence, they took the political authority, they took the economic the means of production of this country, leaving the indigenous people without anything. So some of us were born 5 years after independence, and today we are happy that we are celebrating this independence. It's a legacy. It's a legacy issue. It's an issue. It came out of a protracted battle of our forefathers who fought the colonialists, starting with the Mbuyane and Chadwe, the Chief Mashaya Mombes. They fought against colonialism. Then we had the generation of the nationalist Father Joshua Kwabukong Yongolong Komo. We talk of some of them are fallen and some of them are still living. Comrade Emerson Mnangagwa, who was even arrested for more than a decade for this independence to be what it is. It was a collective effort amongst the youth of that generation then who brought this independence. So to us, a generation which we call, we are the liberated, we were born 5 years after the independence. We are a generation which is enjoying the fruits of the liberators who brought the independence of this country. So it is now our mandate to ensure that what they fought for is not in vain. What they fought for, we protect it. And also, it's also a decade where we should also make sure that what is our legacy as young people. We need to make sure that our legacy, we define our legacy. What is our legacy? Our legacy is to ensure that we make Vision 2030 a reality. Because Vision 2030 was not made for the old. It's for us as a young people. So the youth of 1970s had a legacy. Their legacy was to make sure that they displace colonialism. And our generation now, we have a mandate to make sure that we take this country to a better place in terms of development, working together with our elders. We believe in generational blending, where our elders guide us on what to do. So we have got a legacy that we should do as young people. So this year, as a ZANU-PF Youth League, we are having a theme that we think is very important. We think that we are, we can. The theme is we are, we can. When we say we are, we mean us as Zimbabweans. We can do anything. We can. We are responsible to make sure that Vision 2030 becomes a reality. So 40 years of independence, it's a worthy celebration. We are encouraging all the youth across the political divide in all their form to respect this Independence Day, because it never came, it was not an easy journey. It was a journey which was protracted, and our forefathers, those who are living, and those some who are fallen, sacrificed for us to be what we are. So independence means that we should be productive. Those who are owning land, they should be productive. Those who are who have been given their claim, they should be productive. Wherever you are, you should be productive, so that you have a responsibility and a role to ensure that our country becomes prosperous according to Vision 2030. One of the reasons why there was the second Chimurenga was that most of our people and our ancestors were displaced from the land that they own. So it means that the land that we have now, that Zimbabweans own today, it was a result of a protracted struggle. It was a result of the blood of the sons and daughters of the land. So what this means is that if there is anyone who is owning a piece of land and is not producing on that land and is sitting on that land, it's selling out. There is no selling out that is greater than not being productive on your land. The land must be utilized. People who have land, who got land and are not using it, they should voluntarily surrender it to the state so that youth who need land can also get it. We are saying this is the year of productivity and trade. Young people want land, but we've got some people who are sitting on land. Some people who are just possibly planting what is called sorghum beans, some. And they're not even following up on our leaders. Our leaders are leading by example. President Mnangagwa, he is a successful farmer. He has mechanized, modernized his farm. We have got some young people who are doing well on rented land. So as young people, we are saying it's important that those who have got land and are not using it, they should voluntarily surrender it, because there is no selling out that is greater than not being productive on the land. We need to work. We need people to work and be productive and show they've got something to show off on their land. We cannot be a country that can be said that we are importing some of these products. Yet we have got some people who are sitting on land which they are not being productive on. So they should voluntarily surrender so that youth can also benefit from that land. We talk of the challenges that we faced as a nation throughout the journey of 40-year independence. We have the challenges of sanctions, but we are surviving because those who came before us, they have a history of fighting whatever challenges that they face. So we are here today celebrating on the 18th of April 2020. We are going to have this independence. We're going to celebrate it. We are inspired by the generation of the liberation struggle. That is where we get our strength from. So let's celebrate this independence. We are, we can. We are the Zimbabweans. We are the young people of Zimbabwe. We are the masters of our own destiny. And President Mnangagwa, we are happy that he is making sure that the trajectory that this country is taking will become a success. We are cognizant of the fact that economic reform is not an event, but it's a process. If you look at political histories of nations, you will realize that it's not easy for nations to become where they are supposed to be. But we are happy with the laid down foundations that the foundations with President Mnangagwa's administration has placed accommodates young people. We are talking about the issue of the recent amendment of the constitution where 10 youth are supposed to participate in parliament. That's involvement, that's empowerment. We are talking about the issue, the promise they undertook, the issue of making sure that youth have got access to land. He promised that after land audit, youth are going to be beneficiaries of land, because most of the youth have got the energy. We want this land. And the new dispensation led by President Emmerson Mnangagwa is actually concerned and making sure that we get this land. Youth are allocated this land. So we have got a government, we have got leaders who fought in the liberation struggle. They are in the new dispensation. They are still fighting for the people's cause. And we as the youth, we are happy and we have got every reason to celebrate during this independence.
This message is brought to you by the ZANU-PF Information and Publicity Department.
Pambele ZANU-PF. Pambele ZANU-PF. Kunembo a ZANU-PF. Forward with the ZANU-PF.